A very good evening to all of you, dear students of class 10 ABC. As we all know that we are discussing right now power sharing. So in this short video, we would like to discuss some question answer. In earlier 2-3 lecture, I have given some sort of idea about power sharing. I have told you the example of Sri Lanka and Belgium. And then I told you what is the vertical power sharing and what is horizontal power sharing. And then I compared the situation with Indian circumstances also. So today we would like to solve some question. In this short video, we would like to do some questions that are very important from the point of view of your board examination. These questions may be asked. And after that, I would like to give you some sort of homework also. So a very common question that is asked to you people, that mention the three causes for the civil war in Sri Lanka. This question I provided you earlier also, that mention the three causes that were responsible for the civil war in Sri Lanka. You all know civil war was conducted between Sinhalese and Tamilese in Sri Lanka, Tamil speaking persons and Sinhalese speaking persons. Between these people, a civil war was conducted. So what are the basic three reasons for this war? So here the number first reason that has been given, that their demand for more autonomy to province populated by the Tamil was denied. Actually, Tamil people demanded for more autonomy. As we all know that they wanted some autonomous status and they wanted to have their own rules and regulation. They wanted more participation in political authority also. So that autonomy, what they wanted, due to that thing, Sinhalese rejected their proposal, and that is why a civil war was conducted in Sri Lanka. Second thing, struggles from recognition of Tamil as an official language. Second, what was the second basic cause behind it, the cause of civil war in Sri Lanka? That Tamil people wants that Tamil should be regarded as a official language in Sri Lanka, but Sinhalese people denied it. Sinhalese people were not ready. Struggles for the recognition of Tamil as an official language, for regional autonomy and equality of opportunity, securing education and job field. And another thing, for regional autonomy and equality of opportunity in securing education and job. Tamils were demanded for a kind of securing in government jobs, in education, in the field of education, but this reservation was not provided to them, so that is why they created a war in the country. The third important reason is, in 1980s, several political organizations were formed demanding an independent Tamil Eelam state. Several regional organizations stood up against Sinhalese, and they demanded for, in the year 1980s, they demanded for a separate independent Tamil Eelam state. Eelam means state, Tamil state, in northern and eastern part of Sri Lanka. It soon turned into a civil war. So these are the three reasons of the civil war in Sri Lanka. My question number two is, list the three merits of power sharing. These questions are very much important from the point of view of your board examination, okay? So you should write down it. List the three merits of power sharing. What are the three basic merits of power sharing? How power sharing is beneficial for us? So in this regard, number one, it is the very spirit of democracy, definitely. Power sharing, if we are having a democracy in our country, then power sharing becomes the fundamental things to be observed, okay? It is very spirit of democracy. So, if a democratic country is there in the world, then that country should always have, power sharing from horizontal point of view as well as from vertical point of view. So, this is the first merit. Second, it brings in the unity of nation. What is the second merit? It brings in the unity of the nation. It is responsible for the power sharing is very much responsible for the unity of nation. Okay, how has the democracy and what is the three merits? For third merit, what is the third merit? The third merit is it follows the policy of separation of power, check and balance rule that is provided by Montesquieu. Earlier I said कैसे कैसे सब में पावर बटे हैं और कैसे एक दूसरे को लोग कंट्रोल करते हैं, तो चेक एंड बैलेंस थ्योरी प्रोवाइडेड बाय मॉन्टेस्क्यू इज फॉलोड बाय दिस थिंग. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज हाउ हैज द डेमोक्रेटिकली इलेक्टेड गवर्नमेंट इन श्रीलंका एस्टेब्लिश्ड मेजोरिटेरियन मेजर्स. ओके, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज हाउ हैज द डेमोक्रेटिकली इलेक्टेड गवर्नमेंट इन श्रीलंका एस्टेब्लिश्ड majoritarian measures. Okay, so in 1956 an act was passed, earlier it has been discussed, 1956 mein ek act pass hua tha to recognize Sinhala as the only official language. Aur us act mein kya kaha gaya tha, that Sinhali is the alone official language in Sri Lanka. So the government followed preferential policies that favored Sinhala applicants for university position and government jobs. तो आप ये भी जानते हैं कि कैसे सिंगली बोलने वाले लोगों को सम रिजर्वेशन एंड सम यूनिवर्सिटी पोजीशन वाज अवार्डेड. सो लेटर ऑन व्हाट हैपेंड, प्रोटेक्टेड एंड फास्टर्ड बुद्धिज्म. एंड द थर्ड थिंग, आई मीन इट वाज आल्सो अ पॉलिसी ऑफ सिंगला पीपल दैट दे प्रोटेक्टेड एंड फास्टर्ड बुद्धिज्म. सो बाई इन दीज वे सिंगली आर बुद्धा यूजली सिंगली लैंग्वेज इज स्पोकन मेजोरिटी ऑफ बाई बुद्धिस्ट पीपल. ओके, so by this way I mean in a democratic country like Sri Lanka the elected government of Sinhala established the rule of majoritarian. Okay, majoritarian rule was established in Sri Lanka. Next question, why has Brussels been chosen as the headquarter of European Union? Next question, why is the Brussels has been chosen as the headquarter of European Union? So what is the answer of this question? Because they recognize the existence of regional differences and the cultural diversities and the arrangement, accommodation, they work out in different from any other country and innovative. Okay, they recognize the existence of regional differences and cultural diversities and the arrangement. Now what happened? What happened in Brussels and Belgium? वहाँ पर देखिए फ्रेंच बोलने वालों को भी उतने ही प्रेफरेंस दी गई गवर्नमेंट बनाने के लिए जितना कि डच बोलने वाले लोगों को, है ना. दोनों को बराबर बराबर का महत्व दिया गया, वेदर वो बोलने वाला परसेंट कितना है, 80-20 का रेशियो है कि 70-30 का रेशियो, इट डजेंट मैटर फॉर एनीवन. ठीक है, तो वहां पे एक बैलेंस करके बैलेंस था. देन दे वर्क आउट इन डिफरेंट फ्रॉम एनी अदर कंट्री एंड इज इनोवेटिव. और फिर क्या हुआ, उन्होंने वर्कआउट किया डिफरेंट वेज में और इनोवेटिव वे में काम किया. इट हैज अवॉइडेड सिविल प्रॉब्लम्स एंड डिवीजन ऑफ लिंग्विस्टिक बेसिस, इंस्टीड ब्रॉट स्टेबिलिटी. और अपने यहाँ स्टेबिलिटी लाने के लिए उन्होंने क्या किया, लैंग्वेज डिस्प्यूट को बढ़ावा नहीं दिया. दे डिड नॉट सपोर्ट लैंग्वेज डिस्प्यूट इन फेवर ऑफ ब्रिंगिंग पीस इन देयर कम्युनिटी. देन व्हाट हैपेंड, it has avoided civil problems and division on linguistic basis, instead brought stability. Though complicated, this arrangement was enabled everyone to live together within the same country. And the final thing kya hai ki is establishment ne is tarah ke, although it was little bit complicated I agree, but even then is tarah ke establishment ne ek bahut acche se sabko saath rehne ke liye motivate kiya, sabko saath rehne ke liye aage aane ke liye prerit kiya. The next question is, how is the system of check and balances maintained among the different organs of the government? Power is shared among the different organs of the government. Okay, jaise what is the method, how is the system of check and balances maintained among the different organs of the government? Kaise check and balances ne theory ne power ko balance kiya? So what is the answer, power is shared among the different organs of the government such as legislature, executive and judiciary. We all know that power is shared among the different kind of bodies of government, जैसे legislature, judiciary और executive. सबके अपने अपने power हैं. Then what happened? It allows different organs of the government placed at the same level to exercise different power. ठीक है ना? और हमने ये देखा कि कैसे एक संस्था अपनी ही शक्तियों का प्रयोग करती है, दूसरे की शक्तियों में का without entering into the power area of another institution, how an institution works effectively. We see it. So it allows different organs of the government placed at the same time level to exercise different powers. सबके अपने अपने power हैं, but along with that, along with the utilization of their own power, they try to control the another institution also if the people of that institution boycott some law or make such a kind of law or implement such a kind of policy that is not up to the constitution, up to the rules and regulation of the constitution. Then the last thing is, such a separation ensures that none of the organs can exercise unlimited power. Okay, that is why, because none of the organization can take the benefit of unlimited power. Each organ checks the other. Each organ is, makes a kind of balance. Checks, prevents the other organ for doing something wrong. This result in balance of power, and such a kind of things results in the balance of power. Okay, so these are some short answer type questions from your book. Another one long answer that I would like to discuss with you people, that question number one: how has the Belgian government solved its ethnic problem? You know, ethnic problem. Okay, let's read. How has the Belgian government solved its ethnic problem? So the answer is, the path of accommodation adopted in Belgium. The path of accommodation, accommodation, you know, accommodation means balance. The path of making balance adopted in Belgium. We all know कैसे उन्होंने अपने problem को solve out किया, by making a balance. Okay. Dutch and French speaking ministers shall be equal in the central government. Dutch and French speaking ministers shall be equal in the central government. मैंने अभी बताया ना कैसे उन्होंने ये पॉलिसी लाई कि हम ब्यूरोक्रेसी में, हम मिनिस्टर्स को सेलेक्ट करने में, हम रिजर्वेशन देने के मामले में लैंग्वेज को इक्वली ट्रीट करेंगे. वी विल ट्रीट बोथ द लैंग्वेज इक्वली. बेल्जियम, इट वाज द थिंकिंग ऑफ बेल्जियम पीपल दैट वी विल ट्रीट बोथ द लैंग्वेज एंड स्पीकिंग पर्सन इक्वली व्हाइल वी सेलेक्ट समवन फॉर मिनिस्टर्स ऑन द पोस्ट ऑफ मिनिस्टर और सेलेक्ट समबडी और फ्रॉम द पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू ऑफ ब्यूरोक्रेसी और वेदर इट इज अ मैटर ऑफ education reservation. We will select all the people equally. We will not make any kind of discrimination on the basis of language as it was made in Sri Lanka. Many parts of the central government have been given to state government. The state government is not subordinate to the central government. Okay, the state government is not subordinate to the central, means हमने देखा किस तरह से power को central, state और local government में बांटा गया था. तो वी कम टू नो दैट स्टेट गवर्नमेंट इज नॉट सबॉर्डिनेट टू नेशनल गवर्नमेंट. दोनों गवर्नमेंट, स्टेट गवर्नमेंट एज वेल एज सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट, हैव बीन प्रोवाइडेड इक्वली पावर एंड इक्वली इंपॉर्टेंस. ओके, नो इज सबॉर्डिनेट ऑफ द अनदर वन. द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज, ब्रुसेल्स हैज अ सेपरेट गवर्नमेंट इन विच बोथ कम्युनिटीज हैव इक्वल रिप्रेजेंटेशन. ब्रुसेल्स, यू नो द कैपिटल ऑफ बेल्जियम, हैज इट्स सेपरेट गवर्नमेंट. ओके, एंड ब्रुसेल्स गवर्नमेंट में क्या था कि वहां पर इक्वली रिप्रेजेंटेशन दिया गया था फ्रेंच और डच लोगों को. ठीक है, ब्रुसेल्स हैज सेपरेट गवर्नमेंट इन विच बोथ द कम्युनिटीज हैव इक्वल रिप्रेजेंटेशन. फोर्थ पॉइंट इज, देयर इज अ थर्ड काइंड ऑफ गवर्नमेंट कॉल्ड कम्युनिटी गवर्नमेंट इलेक्टेड बाई पीपल. और लोकल लेवल पर क्या है वहां पर, थर्ड काइंड ऑफ गवर्नमेंट. थर्ड काइंड ऑफ गवर्नमेंट मीन्स, आई मीन सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट नंबर वन, स्टेट गवर्नमेंट नंबर, पॉइंट नंबर टू, एंड द थर्ड इज लोकल सेल्फ गवर्नमेंट और थर्ड कम्युनिटी गवर्नमेंट इन बेल्जियम इलेक्टेड बाय पीपल बिलोंगिंग टू डच, फ्रेंच एंड जर्मन, नो मैटर वेयर दे लिव. और वो जो बनती थी थर्ड काइंड ऑफ गवर्नमेंट जो थी, जो कम्युनिटी गवर्नमेंट थी, वो डच, फ्रेंच और जर्मन, आई मीन इट वाज अ मिक्सचर ऑफ, इट वाज अ कॉकटेल ऑफ, इट वाज अ कंसोलिडेटेड फॉर्म ऑफ डच, जर्मन एंड फ्रेंच पीपल. ओके, देयर इज अ थर्ड काइंड ऑफ गवर्नमेंट. ओके, दिस पॉइंट हैज बीन डिस्कस्ड. When many countries of Europe together to form the European Union, Brussels was chosen as its headquarters. And the many countries of European Union, they tried to, they formed this institution named European Union. At that time, they selected Brussels as their headquarters. They selected Brussels as headquarters. Okay. So these are some points. On the basis of these points, we can say that Belgium government, by the बाई अडॉप्टिंग ऑल दीज फॉलोइंग पॉइंट्स सॉल्व इट्स एथनिक प्रॉब्लम. वहां पर जाति का, वहां पर नस्ल का, वहां पर रेस का कोई भेद नहीं हुआ. Then next question, explain the four forms of power sharing with example. Okay, very important question. Explain the four forms of power sharing with examples. So, point number one, सबसे पहले क्या है, किस type की power sharing होती है? That is horizontal distribution of power. Number एक power sharing किस type का है? That is horizontal distribution of power. इसको कहते हैं between the organs of the government, legislature, executive, judiciary. Horizontal, you know, parallel. And vertical means 90 degree. Horizontal means parallel. Okay? What should I say? Longitude. No, latitude. Latitude lines. Horizontal means latitude lines. Parallel to one another. And vertical means longitude lines. 90 degree angle. Okay? So, horizontal distribution of power. Number one. Between the... किसको हम कहेंगे horizontal distribution of power है? जहां पर बिटवीन द पावर शेयरिंग इज मेड बिटवीन द ऑर्गन्स ऑफ गवर्नमेंट लाइक लेजिस्लेचर एग्जीक्यूटिव एंड जुडिशरी. इंडिया ऐसी कंट्री जहां पर पावर को एग्जीक्यूटिव, जुडिशरी और द थर्ड वन इज लेजिस्लेचर के बीच में बांटा जाता है, ऐसी कंट्री को बेटा हॉरिजॉन्टल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ पावर कहते हैं. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इंडिया. इंडिया में याद रखिएगा पावर शेयरिंग किस हिसाब से है, हॉरिजॉन्टल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन है. वहां पर लेजिस्लेचर, एग्जीक्यूटिव और उसके बाद जुडिशरी, सबको अलग अलग पावर दिया गया है. सेकेंड इज वर्टिकल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ पावर. वर्टिकल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन मीन्स वर्टिकल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन 90 डिग्री एंगल पर. वहां पर कौन कौन है, शक्ति किसमें बांटी जाती है, सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट, स्टेट गवर्नमेंट एंड लोकल सेल्फ गवर्नमेंट. सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट, स्टेट गवर्नमेंट एंड लोकल लेवल गवर्नमेंट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इंडिया. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इंडिया. बेल्जियम भी इसी श्रेणी में आएगा, है ना, चूंकि वहां भी सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट, स्टेट गवर्नमेंट और क्या है, कम्युनिटी गवर्नमेंट. तो इन द सेम वे सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट, स्टेट गवर्नमेंट एंड लोकल सेल्फ गवर्नमेंट पावर, दिस मेथड ऑफ पावर शेयरिंग इज कॉल्ड व्हाट कैन वी कॉल इट, वर्टिकल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ पावर. ओके. थर्ड इज पावर शेयरिंग अमंग डिफरेंट पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज. आपको पता है ना, ये भी बताया गया था कि अनदर मेथड है पावर शेयरिंग का, क्या है कि पावर शेयरिंग अमंग various kind of political parties, state political parties, national level political parties, local level political parties, regional level political parties, इनके पास भी जो कुछ power होती है, that is another form of power sharing. अगला है power sharing among pressure groups. Pressure groups, I have already told you that the group of people of the same strategy or mindset works for their own benefit and create a kind of pressure upon the running government. Such a kind of groups are called pressure groups. So pressure groups are also there, and they are not the part of political party. They are something special, and some power are also given to them for the maintenance of peace and prosperity of a particular region. Then this is also a type of distribution of power sharing and movements in India, coalition government, and some movements also, some good movements are given some power. For example, in India, coalition government sometimes take place. Okay. This is the mixture power. I mean, suppose that in a coalition, what do you mean by coalition government? Coalition government means a kind of government that is made with the help of various kind of different parties. I mean, it is not a single party that is covering the majority seats in the election, but due to the failure of not getting majority, two or more than two parties combine themselves with one another and they form the government. That government is called coalition government. Saajha Sarkar. So in such a way, we can think that power sharing is conducted. So these are very important points for you people. So these were some important questions for you that I have discussed today. So from tomorrow, I would like to discuss you something very special, and I would like to brief this chapter from your NCERT book also. Although I have briefed it already, but I would like to start your chapter from NCERT book. Okay, I am just teaching you this chapter in detail so that when the school reopens for you, then you should not have any kind of problem with you people. Okay, you should know that what are the fact and what kind of strategy you have to adopt for reading this chapter. Okay, that is why I am teaching this chapter in detail. These are some questions. One question is, how many questions I taught you? Mention the three causes of the civil war in Sri Lanka. Then list the three merits of power sharing. Then third question, how has the democratically elected government of Sri Lanka established majoritarian measures? Then why has the Brussels been chosen as the headquarters of European Union? Then how is the system of check and balances maintaining among the different organs of the government? Then two long answers are there. How has the Belgian government solved its ethnic problem? Explain the four forms of power sharing with examples. These questions I have discussed with you today. And now some sort of homework for you people. You have to write down only three questions. I am providing you. Question number one. Why is power sharing good for democracies? Why is power sharing good for democracies? Why is it desirable in the modern world? Question number one. Question number two. Explain how civil war can be turned down. Explain how the civil war can be turned down and peace be restored in Sri Lanka. क्या हो सकते हैं? दो पॉइंट बताइए जिससे श्रीलंका में सिविल वॉर खत्म हो जाता और वहां पीस स्टोर कर दिया, पीस हो जाती, वहां शांति हो जाती. नेक्स्ट, गिव अ कंपैरेटिव एनालिसिस बिटवीन बेल्जियम एंड इंडिया. अब ये क्वेश्चन आपको करना है, आपको बेल्जियम के पॉलिटिकल पावर में और इंडिया के पॉलिटिकल पावर में कंपैरेटिव एनालिसिस करके बताना है कि कैसे दोनों कंट्री के पावर मेल खाते हैं और कहां कहां पर डिफरेंशिएशन. गिव अ कंपैरेटिव एनालिसिस बिटवीन बेल्जियम एंड इंडिया. ओके, एंड द लास्ट क्वेश्चन फॉर यू, व्हाट इज अ कम्युनिटी गवर्नमेंट, हाउ इज दिस फॉर्म इन बेल्जियम. व्हाट इज अ कम्युनिटी गवर्नमेंट एंड हाउ इज दिस फॉर्म इन बेल्जियम. दीज आर सम क्वेश्चंस फॉर यू पीपल. यू आर रिक्वेस्टेड टू आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन एंड सेंड इट टू मी ऑन व्हाट्सएप और इन योर गूगल ई क्लासरूम ऑल्सो. यू कैन सेंड एंड सेंड इट टू मी ऑन व्हाट्सएप ऑल्सो. आई एम लुकिंग दैट क्लास 10 के बच्चे जो हैं ABC के, वो बिल्कुल भी होमवर्क नहीं कर रहे हैं. ठीक है, दैट इज नॉट गुड. You should do your homework. That will be good for you, I think. So please maintain your homework and complete the homework also. So thanks a lot for joining me today. I hope you all will be very happy. Take care about yourself. I have discussed some question of first chapter with you people today, and I would like to start now the same chapter, the first chapter from NCERT book also. Okay. So have a take care about yourself and be alert. Inside your house, follow all the rules and regulations of lockdown, and I hope you will meet tomorrow at the same time, and you all will be happy, I think so. And thanks for joining me. We'll meet soon again. Bye, take care.